today we are going to build 868 MHz JPole antenna for Meshtastic use. It is very simple and easy to build. YouTubers want likes and subscribers, but for this video, I want that everyone who wants to build a JPole antenna should be able to build it without any problems by watching this video. Let's start. I am building this antenna with a 20 mm copper tape. You can use aluminium foil in place of copper with the same dimensions. And you can use electrical wire as well. I am building this antenna on a ruler or scale. Copper tape is a sticker-like tape. You need to peel off the paper on the back side of it. Please try not to break the tape, because if you break the tape and you continue by overlapping the new part of the tape on the previous part of the tape, it will be electrically isolated. This is because of the gum or the sticking material on the back of the tape. If you have to add another part of the tape, you need to place it over the previous part of the tape and then you need to solder it. You can use multimeter or ohm meter to check the connectivity. I am using IPEX U.FL to SMA pigtail. I am cutting IPEX side of the pigtail and soldering the wires to the antenna. You need to make sure that the center conductor is connected to the longer part of the antenna, while the braid is connected to the shorter or matching part of the antenna. I am using hot glue to keep the connector in place. SMA connectors are not like SO239, PL259, F connectors, N connectors, etc. SMA connectors comes in four genders, that is male, female, reverse polarity male and reverse polarity female. So be watchful while selecting a connector. Just connected the VNA to see how antenna is performing on the given frequency of 868 MHz. Longer part of the antenna is the actual antenna that resonates on the given frequency. Shorter part is for the matching purpose. If the antenna readings are not as desired, we need to mark a part where we can increase or decrease the length. For longer part, I marked it as 30 mm. Center of this 30 mm is top of the current antenna. So we can add 15 mm if needed, or we can subtract 15 mm from the current length. For the shorter arm, I will use 15 mm to play with the adjustments. And again, from this 15 mm, I would use around 7, 7.5 mm to reduce the length, and the similar 7 or 7.5 mm to increase the length. So in the first observation, we see that the frequency is higher. That is 886 MHz. So we cut 3 mm of the tape and check again. Now we see that the resonant frequency moves upward to 892 MHz. It is an indication that our conductor is shorter than the resonant length. But before going ahead and increase the length of the main conductor, I would like to cut the shorter side by 2 mm to see if antenna resonates. Now the resonant frequency moves to 895 MHz, which is again higher than the previous two readings. So it confirms that we have a shorter length antenna and we need to increase its length. So I added a few millimeters of length to electrically connect new length with the old length. I have to clean and solder it. Now testing with the VNA, we find antenna tuned to 868 MHz with 1.09 SWR. On VNA server, we have a good news. This is tuned to 868 MHz with a VSWR of 1.075 and a return loss of minus 28 dB. So I am happy with it. Have you tried to build this antenna? How did it go? Please share your experience. If you find any problems, please ask in the comments section.